Ron DeSantis' presidential campaign may be over before it even officially starts. Last week, Ron DeSantis not only ignored massive floods in his state so that he could go out and do a book signing and a campaign event in Ohio, but he also immediately came back and signed a heartbeat bill. It's called the Florida Heartbeat Protection Act, which bans any and all abortions after 6 weeks, a period of time that, by the way, most women wouldn't even know that they were pregnant yet. So he signed it. Florida now has one of the most restrictive abortion bans on the books. It is official. It is law now. And at that moment, a major Republican businessman and donor by the name of Thomas Peterffy said this to the Financial Times. "I am more reluctant to back him," talking about DeSantis. "We are waiting to see who among the primary candidates is most likely to be able to win the general and then put all of our firepower behind them. Because of his stance on abortion and book banning, myself and a bunch of friends are holding our powder dry." Maggie Haberman with the New York Times has reported that other donors, as she put it, donors are getting worried. Because here we have a major Republican donor who had already said, "I'm going to back Ron DeSantis." And now he's out there telling reporters like, "Listen, I'm kind of done right now." He's not 100% done. And he says he's totally not backing Trump, and then Trump will be the nominee and he'll back him anyway. It's what they do. But he's like, I did support this dude, but now I can't. Until he's the only nominee left, and then I will. But I got my friends to pull out. We're not going to give this asshole any more money. He's doing horrible things that are going to kill the Republican Party in 2024 because these idiots didn't learn. Like, that's the funniest part. Weren't the Republicans supposed to be doing an autopsy report? I mean, Kellyanne Conway was involved in it. They got Tony Perkins involved in it. Whatever happened to that report? Why did we do so bad in 2022? Because of these issues, because of the book banning, because of the abortion bans, because of the Supreme Court overturning Roe. All of that played a massive role in your party not picking up the 70 seats that you had projected. And, of course, not taking back the Senate because you let Donald Trump pick your Senate candidates, even though he had just been raided by the FBI. Like, why did you not pay attention to your own autopsy report? And the answer to that question, of course, is because they didn't really do it. They know today all of the problems that their party has with the voters. They're not that deluded. Now, they'll go out in the media and they'll say like, "Well, we don't know why we're losing young voters." They said that last week. But deep down, they do know. They just can't admit it. So they know what's happening. They're pretending to not know. And they're watching in horror as all of the things that they only once promised to do, you know, just to get their voters riled up to go vote for them. Now they're actually doing it. They're witnessing the backlash. And now they're like, "Oh, damn, I didn't think we were actually gonna do these things," right? We'd just been threatening to do it for decades. And y'all are really doing it. The voters are mad, the donors are mad, and there isn't a damn thing the Republican Party can do about it, even though they know it's killing them.
This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.